Hello, darlings. Look, it's natural light. Bedroom window of my new bedroom. There's the backyard. There's the boat port where we used to have a boat. I've changed bedrooms. I was in the big yellow bedroom. And I was using this smaller bedroom just to keep books in. And then I decided I needed a change. So I brought in my bed, and it's my new bedroom, and it's just really wonderful. It's cozy. I love being in here. It's just this was my bedroom when I was 5 years old, when the house was just built. So I've got just a couple of books, and I've got my my machine here for when my asthma gets really bad. And I put on my little thing here, and I adjust it. And I turn on the switch, and then the mist helps me to breathe. Isn't that lovely? It's just so wonderful growing old, isn't it? So then I have my little, I have just a little bedside stand right here with my, just a few books. My Centipede Press box set of Michael Cisco, the Lovecraft Penguin editions, Lovecraft Poe, and I have a little room left here reserved for the Penguin Clark Ashton Smith, which will be published this year. And then I've got it's really cozy. Here's a calendar with me in a bathtub. And there's some books. And here's some more books and my records, my mostly Shakespeare records. I had my stereo in the living room, so I brought it here. Here's the Incesticide, Nirvana, Blue Disc. Pretty nice. Been listening to records. Barbra Streisand, of course, H.P. Lovecraft, and my mom's collection of, what would that be called, Blue China, or I don't know what it is. Anyway, so I really, really like it in here. I've slept here for two nights. Really comfortable, and it's just cozy. This is my bedroom when I was 5 years old, and I thought this will be a great bedroom to die in. So this is where eventually, I'll kick off. Wonderful. What a happy day that will be. So the mail came, and oh, wow. I got a big royalty check. A royalty check. Look, royalties. It's $1.17. No wonder I'm looking for a job. I? Oh well. You know, I recently made a sale to a book, and it's a reprint. A reprint anthology is a really important anthology because of the editor. But the payment is 1 penny per word. And I thought, wow, that's exactly what Weird Tales was paying H.P. Lovecraft in the 1920s. Things have not progressed financially for writers in our genre. Yeah, I got a book from that I ordered from Amazon. Zeliot. Jesus of Nazareth. And this is a controversial book because its author is a Muslim, and there's been a Christian uproar. How could a Muslim write about the life of Jesus? This sacrilege. But I saw him interviewed on TV, and he's quite intelligent, and he's a scholar on religions. So all you born again Christian bigots, fuck you. You know, your stupid bigotry. It's because somebody's a Muslim. Anyway, I have a whole I collect books on Jesus. There's Jesus and believing Christ. What's that one? Jesus of Nazareth. The changing faces of Jesus. Rabbi Jesus, because of course Jesus was a Jewish teacher, a rabbi. Excavating Jesus. The first edition of the New Testament. What else I have? Jesus, a Revolutionary Biography. Oh my God. The Jesus Quest. How the Search of Jesus Lost Its Way. And Christ, the Experience of Jesus as Lord. And this one called Christ, A Crisis in the Life of God. And, oi! That's not Jesus. That's Titus Crow. I'm reading. I'll get to that later. So now I have a new book on Jesus. Jesus. Zeliot. The Life and Times of Jesus of Nazareth. In Zeliot, Reza Aslan doesn't just synthesize research and reimagine a lost world, though he does those things very well. He does for religious history what Bertolt Brecht did for playwriting. Aslan rips Jesus out of all the contexts we thought he belonged in and holds him forth as someone entirely new. This is Jesus as a passionate Jew, a violent revolutionary, a fanatical ideologue, an odd and scary and extraordinarily interesting man. So the emphasis there's on the historical Jesus movement is to find Jesus in history and to find Jesus, the historical man, as opposed to the supernatural Messiah. Now, I'm writing a novel. I started writing a novel Oh, I'm taking nuts because these are good for the heart and they're good for digestive. Well, maybe they're not good for the heart, but they're... Honey, what are you doing? Kitty, kitty, be good. Don't. Let's see, I'm. Anyway, this says nuts and cranberries, frozen raisins, dried raisins, and granola, tons of stuff. So I'm writing a novel, and I'm going to make it 43,000 words. And the first half of it is going to take place in Dreamland, Lovecraft's Dreamland. What are you doing, Kat? And the second half is going to take place in Sesqua Valley. So I'm rereading Dream Quest of Unknown Kadath. I find it a very silly work. On many aspects, I find it delightful, but mostly I just find it very silly. You know, it's like, so my dreamland is going to be radically different from Lovecraft's dreamland, because I'm going to be serious, girlfriend. And the premise of my novel is that Nyarlathotep has abducted a child of Sesqua Valley to the dreamlands. And to have a child of Sesqua Valley there warps and mutilates the atmosphere of dreamland. And that way I can thus change aspects of dreamland and make it the kind of dreamland I would want to go visit. So then I was thinking, well, Brian Lumley wrote a series of novels set in the Dreamlands, and I was thinking of rereading those. I've actually only read one, and I thought it was bloody awful. And it was, you know, rip-roaring adventure. The main character's name is Hero. So I've decided not to read Brian Lumley's Dreamland novels. I was gonna, they're available on Amazon. I think some of them are selling for a penny a piece. But even at that price, I just can't be bothered. But I decided I wanted to read, I haven't read it for decades, The Transition of Titus Krum. So that's what I'm doing. And that's all my news. I just love my new bedroom. It's really, it's cozy. When I listen to my music, the music is right there. I've got wonderful reading light from the window behind me. So it's cool. I like this. All right, my darlings. I hope you're doing well. And I'll talk to you later. Shalom, my darlings.